Let's first start with even and odd functions graphically. A function is called an even function if for every input x, f of x equals f of negative x. The graph of an even function is symmetric about the y-axis. Here's an example of an even function graph. You can see that for this graph, it is symmetric about the y-axis. So if I took this half and I reflected it about the y-axis, I would get this other half of the graph. Another way to look at it, if we look at f of x, so let's look at an example such as f of 2. So f of 2 is 4, and f of negative 2 is also 4. That's a result of being symmetric about the y-axis. For an odd function, a function is called an odd function if for every input x, f of negative x equals the opposite of f of x. The graph of an odd function is symmetric about the origin. So what we mean by that is that if you take the origin, which is the point 0, 0, so take half of this graph, so we'll take this half, and we rotate it around the origin. So that means essentially you're rotating it 180 degrees, or another way to look at it is you rotate it first around the x-axis, and then again around the y-axis. That's when you fully done it around the origin. So that's so you can check for symmetry. So in this example, it is symmetric about the origin, so this is an odd function. And going back to the other one, it was symmetric about the y-axis, so this was an even function. For more examples of even and odd functions graphically, click here. There are three steps we can follow to determine if a function is even, odd, or neither if we're given a formula. This is how you determine if functions are even or odd algebraically. Step 1. First, find f of negative x. If f of negative x equals f of x, you're done. The function is even. That is always great when that happens because it's less work. However, if it does not equal f of x, then we have to move on to step 2. For step 2, next we'll find the opposite of f of x, in other words, negative f of x. If f of negative x equals negative f of x, then the function is odd. I'll say that again because that sounded really confusing. So we've already found f of negative x, and we defined on the last page that a function is odd if that equals the opposite of f of x. Step 3, if that's not the case, then we can say that the function is neither. So let's actually put this into practice. Determine algebraically whether the following functions are even, odd, or neither. Let's start with the one on the left. First, step 1, find f of negative x. That means anywhere I see an x, I'm going to replace it with negative x. So I get 3 times negative x squared plus 4. Negative x squared is negative x times negative x, which is x squared. So I'm left with 3x squared plus 4. So now in step 1, it says that I need to check if f of negative x equals f of x. And in that case, the function is even. So is this the same as my original function? And the answer is yes. So because f of negative x is the same as the original function, I can say that this function is even. Let's move on to the next one. Again, starting with step 1, find f of negative x. So we get f of negative x equals 2 times negative x cubed minus negative x. This gives us negative x cubed is negative x times negative x, which is x squared, times another negative x, which is negative x cubed. So when I simplify, I get negative 2x cubed plus x. In the first step, it says I need to see, is this the same as the original function? In this case, it is not. So I know this function is not even. Now I need to check and see if it's odd. So again, if it's odd, f of negative x is going to equal the opposite of f of x. So let's see what the opposite of f of x is. So that's going to be multiplying negative 1 times 2x cubed minus x, which is negative 2x cubed plus x. These are actually the same. So because f of negative x equals negative f of x, I can say that this function is odd. Let's look at the last example. F of negative x. Negative x quantity cubed plus 2 times negative x squared. That gives us negative x cubed plus 2x squared. Because negative x squared is negative x times negative x, which is positive x squared. Is this the same as our original function? No, because this has negative x cubed in front, and that one does not. So this is not the same as f of x. So now I move on to step 2. So we'll find the opposite of f of x. All right, so when I do the opposite of this function, I end up getting negative x cubed minus 2x squared. Now I need to check to see if that is the same as f of negative x. Well, again, f of negative x is negative x cubed plus 2x squared, and negative f of x is negative x cubed minus 2x squared. So these are not the same function. So now I can move down to step 3. Since that happened and this happened, I can say that the function is neither.